time to call your lawyer.
Which we're going to actually already have done. We're going to now see what Bruce thinks of our question of the week. But before we get started with Ask the Lawyer, let me remind you what you're about to hear is general legal conversation. And it should not be taken as specific advice in your specific circumstances. To get that, you've got to sit down face-to-face with a legal professional. Now, Bruce L. Schreiner & Associates do offer free consultations, so by all means, take advantage of that. I'll tell you how to contact them in just a quick moment. In the meantime, some great general legal advice we could pass along to absolutely everybody. That is, don't make any statements, don't let anyone record any conversations, and don't sign anything until you've spoken to a legal professional. Please help me now welcome Bruce L. Schreiner, attorney for the injured. Good morning, Bruce.
Good morning, Todd.
How have things been with you?
It's been a great week, Todd, and I'm good. Happy to talk to you and answer any challenging questions that your listeners may have.
You know, at times you have said some of the questions that get submitted here are ones that kind of take you back to law school, like they'd be on a test or something like that, right?
That is correct.
Okay, well, let's see if today is reminiscent of the good old days when you were in law school. However, of course, apply all your years of experience to the answer. Are you ready?
I am ready, Todd.
Okay. Today's question says this. 2 years ago, I was injured while shopping at a local franchise convenience store. It had been raining, and when I came through the front door, I slipped on the wet floor. When I fell, I came down hard on my knee, which resulted in a tear to the meniscus. I needed surgery to repair the damage and then extended rehab. All my out-of-pocket medical expenses and lost income, I am an independent CPA, has reached $38,500. $10,000 is my medical insurance out of pocket. The franchise store has since closed. And from my understanding, the franchise owner has filed for bankruptcy. Do I have the right to go after the store's insurance company to recoup my expenses and losses? I tried to do this on my own since it was a local store, and the manager said she should have mopped up the wet area or posted a sign. And that's where I suddenly had a cold chill go down my spine. I tried to do this on my own. Oh, no. Please contact a legal professional. That's what we're doing right now. Bruce, what do you make of this situation?
Well, it all depends on the timing of what's going on. But fortunately, when a negligent party has insurance, you could still collect up to the limits of insurance, even if they go bankrupt.
Oh, okay.
So when this person got hurt, you know, if the store was responsible, they owed a debt to the injured person. When they filed for bankruptcy, they extinguished that debt. However, if the store, which most stores do, have insurance, as long as they timely file a claim, and that's where the timing comes in, that's important. As long as they timely file a claim with bankruptcy, they could stay the bankruptcy action and pursue a resolution up to the limits of insurance.
I see. Once again, the timing is critical here, though.
The timing is always critical in these cases.
Yeah. We were speculating a company that's financially strapped and eventually declares bankruptcy and goes out of business might not have been paying insurance premiums towards the end of their existence. What if they didn't have insurance at that point?
They didn't have insurance, unfortunately. If they had filed for bankruptcy, they'd be SOL.
That's what I was afraid of. Well, we don't know until some investigating is done, some digging is done, a lot of questions are asked, and the kind of questions that legal professionals such as you and your associates will find a much easier time getting answers to, quite frankly. So she needs to speak to a legal professional as soon as possible.
That's very good advice.
Yesterday, if not today. Bruce, thank you so much for helping. This is a really tricky one, too. Work our way through this and figure it out. Once again, I'm sure a sigh of relief on behalf of whoever wrote us this, and I look forward to talking to you again next week.
Yeah, I can't wait till next Wednesday.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up again for Bruce L. Schreiner, attorney for the injured and the answer of the week. And if you have been in an accident, that's what was next on my mind, and would like some more immediate advice than just submitting your question on the radio, please call the local office, the Port Charlotte office of Bruce L. Schreiner & Associates at 941-743-7777. 941-743-7777. Tell them Todd Matthews sent you from Kix Country 92.9.